Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Stock, and I'm here to bring you the latest and greatest information that I can find in the stock market. Today, we're still talking about BNGO. I really didn't plan to stay on this one for so long. The reason that I'm still here is that I really think that there's some education needed around this stock and around trading penny stocks in general. I do have a forecast for this stock for what I think is going to go on and what I would like to see go on as we go forward as this price continues to change wildly. You know, what I think is going to happen today, we'll look at the pre-market. Hopefully, yesterday's video got delayed because of the upload time was about an hour. It was supposed to drop around 9 o'clock and it ended up being after the market opened. So this one, I wanted to come out in the pre-market so that you guys can see it, hear what I have to say about it. And you know, for me, it helped me inform my decisions. Maybe some of that information will help inform your perspective surrounding this stock. All right, remember, this video is for entertainment purposes only. You still need to contact a financial professional in order to make a sound financial decision. You also need to make sure that you do your own due diligence before you make any trades in the stock market. Again, this is my opinion, it's entertainment, but you might find some of it at least informative. All right, let's get ready to rock. All right, quickly before we get started, down in the description, click the link for Webull. That link will get you 2 free stocks if you sign up. Deposit $100, get 2 more free stocks. You have until January the 15th to get that done. I get a free one for you guys signing up. I appreciate it. I don't want to spend a lot of time with it. Let's move on to the next thing. Subscribe, like, hit the notification bell, share it with your friends. Really help support this channel so that I can keep on spending more time researching these stocks and trying to bring you the best information that I can. Last thing, I apologize ahead of time. Again, it's going to be a little bit rough. I don't have a lot of time for editing. I really want to get this out to you guys, but I really think that you'll find my information something that not a lot of people are really talking about in a lot of detail. I'd like to start off with the SEC filing. So I wrote some notes down. So basically, one of the lenders they had an agreement with, they had to make sure that they made their payments on time. Something happened with whatever finances, financial agreement was between them. And as such, a waiver had to be filed, but a waiver meant that Bionano had to give away some of their finances in order to make good on that waiver. So the waiver does cost something from Bionano. That's not great because they already don't have a lot of money, but it is much better than going into default, because if they went into default, then they have to pay back the money in full. And there's a lot of other implications that go along with that. Check the SEC filings. One is the waiver from yesterday. Another one is the quarterly report. I believe it's November the 13th, 2020. And then the one that was on March 14th of 2019. Those three documents, if you read through them, you'll find out a little bit more about what non-compliance means. I jotted down in my notes the bottom line, Bionano, BNGO, they need money in order to operate. That waiver means that they have a little less money to operate, but it's not horrible news. The stock price has jumped up a lot. They have a really good chance at a public offering or a direct offering, some sort of capital raise. I think it'll happen next week if I had to put my money on it. So that's the best that I can guess at. I don't think that they want to do it too soon. If this thing rips down and they do a capital raise and it drops them below a dollar, it resets that 10-day window for non-compliance with the NASDAQ, and then they would face, you know, further consequences for delisting. I don't think that's going to happen. I think they'll wait until next week during the symposium, and then maybe they'll open it back up again. All right, so let's switch to the chart and talk about today. All right, guys. So here again, Webull desktop, we're looking at the 30-minute window. I usually like the dailies, but this thing happens so quickly. The daily chart, it's not much help at all. You just see a wall. The help there is that this is hugely run up. So if it pulls back or if it corrects, that is totally natural. And I'll get more to that in a moment. So looking at the 30-minute chart where we can see that entire run up happen in a little bit more detail, you can see towards the end of the trading day, we had that that peak. It really spiked up on us right at the closing bell hour. And then immediately in the closing market, it ripped right back down, but it does form that nice double top for us. That's an area of resistance. And then you can see in the after hours, it dropped off. And then right here is when the pre-market opened again.
we have a big drop, and then these little tiny bars here. This is somewhat good news for us. You know, whether we're on the bear side or the bull side of this, we want to see this thing calm down, and it is calming down. I talked about the Bollinger Bands before, and I mentioned yesterday that we want to see them narrow, and they're narrowing a little bit. Here they're going a little bit wide. You can see them dropping below two standard deviations. So I think that in the pre-market anyway, this thing might recover a little bit. But really what we want to see is this stock settle. We want to see it enter a nice consolidation where it locks in a price for a little while to get some more confidence in our decision going forward so that we can plan for the next breakout. As far as today, will it be bullish? Will it be bearish? In my opinion, I think it'll trade sideways, or it will correct to bring it back down a little bit to more of a price where it should be. So some people locked in the profits yesterday. For me, I felt like it was really run up. If you look at this breaking two standard deviations, that's pretty high. That's a good run up. And plus you can see this earlier sort of double top that we have here. They're good points that if you want to lock in some of your profits that you should. Again, because the stock's run up, it doesn't mean it's not a healthy company, or I'm sorry, that doesn't have healthy fundamentals, or it doesn't have promise going forward, because I've already addressed that. I believe that it does. I would like to, should this come back down, and if it comes back down really far, if it comes back down to the $2 or $3 mark, I can tell you I'll put in twice as much as I initially did on this. I'll take a larger position. I've done more work on the company, and there's a lot more information out now than when I originally started, and I can see that price as we go forward over the next few weeks coming back up again. That's the best informed opinion that I have right now. Let me put on, get rid of the Bollinger Bands there, go into the drawings and bring out one of the rays. If we look across the bottoms of this thing, again, this is a really big run-up day, and I think the reason that we're so, that we had that run-up like we did is that the bulls were waiting so long from the 31st of December all the way until January the 4th to actually trade this thing again. I think that there was a lot of excitement. There was a lot of energy. We had the study come out regarding Temple Grandin and autism saying, hey, Saphyr was used. I'd like to continue using Saphyr. And that's good news that there's demand for it. So we see some of that price factored in. Maybe a little bit too much at this point, that good news in such a popular and hyped up stock. Any good news really stands the chance to pump this price up further. Any bad news will rip it down really fast. And we could see some of that in the post-market here with the SEC filing with the waiver. I don't think long-term that that waiver is bad news. Default would be much worse news. And they being Bionano, they address that directly in their SEC filing. So that's not me talking, that's in the filing itself. So that part I can stand by, and I told you what dates to check those out, so check those out. So according, if we follow this linear progression, 443 all up to 479, I would consider possibly entering somewhat of a position then, a small position, and maybe if it continues to drop dollar cost averaging down until we really get that next catalyst that bumps us up. More institutional investment, ARKG would be huge. Really good news coming out of the symposium. Those are things that we want to look for. We want to try and find the things that are going to make us money as investors. Let me summarize with what I see here. Today, if it goes sideways, I won't be surprised. This thing needs to rest a little bit. If it goes up, I won't be surprised because it's a really hyped up stock right now. If it continues to drop and correct, well, you know, after a bull run like this, dropping and correcting is the normal thing to do. I don't have a specific direction on this. I can tell you what I would like to see. I would like to see it either correct so that there's more buying opportunities, especially for those people who happen to miss this or maybe got in at, you know, $6.50, $7, that they could dollar cost average down a little bit to make it a little bit more cheaper, a little bit more profitable for them in the future. But as far as what's going to happen next, this stock is too whippy. I can't make that call. Trade carefully. If you got profits, you know, think about taking some of those profits. Those are just things that I would do. I can't tell you what to do. You should contact a financial professional. You should do your own due diligence before making any of these trades.
All right. That's what I have for you today. I hope that you found it informative. Click the Webull link. Click the referral link. Get your two free stocks for signing up. Your two free stocks for the $100. My two free stocks because you helped me out. Do your due diligence. Remember, this is for entertainment purposes only. Contact a financial professional before making any financial decisions. I'm Dr. Stock. Thanks for rocking with me. Now get out there and make that money.